Hi, I'm Jen Posner with the John DiBella Show on Philadelphia's classic rock 102.9 MGK. You might also recognize me as the St. Mary Mom, a title in which I'm proud to be associated with. Well, today we're going to be talking about something that is very near and dear to my heart, maternity services at St. Mary. And I'm really interested in this because about 6.5 years ago, my son Liam was born here, premature, totally unexpected. And despite that fact, everything was top-notch from start to finish, and I couldn't have been happier with the services here. You hear that? That beautiful little song? That is Brahms' Lullaby. And the staff here at St. Mary's hits a little special button every time a baby is born, and that song floods the hallways to let people know that a new life has come into this world. So come on, let's take a peek and see what's going on. Let's just start off talking about some of the enhancements that are coming to the labor and delivery unit and the NICU. Fill me in on that.
Oh, sure. Well, it's a whole overhaul, Jen. And aesthetically, it'll just be much prettier, and we're pretty excited about that. There's going to be more labor and delivery rooms, which is great for us. You know, we'll have 2 more labor and delivery rooms. When people come in for triage, at this point, sometimes there's just curtain separating. They'll have individual rooms. Mm-hmm. And we'll also have recovery rooms that are separate also for recovery rooms for C-sections. Mm-hmm. And the NICU will be completely transformed from just an open area to individual bays. You know, and so that'll be just fantastic. I really think people choose St. Mary for the personal touch, mm-hmm. because people treat you like they'd want their family member treated. And I think that's just a unique aspect of this hospital, that people always think, how would I want to be treated? How would I want my mother, my sister, my brother to be treated?
From start to finish, when I came here, I saw you and all of your partners when I was admitted with premature labor.
Sure.
And your calm nature, your bedside manner, all of you in that practice from start to finish took what was an extremely stressful situation for me and made it into a very happy ending. Joining me now is Marie Schickler, the Administrative Director of Nursing at St. Mary Medical Center. With regards to maternity services, tell me how St. Mary has grown with this service since the hospital opened, seeing this is a time where a lot of hospitals are cutting back on maternity, even eliminating maternity altogether, but you guys are expanding.
Yeah, absolutely. We have been in the maternity business for about 40 years now, and so very exciting that our community has really chose St. Mary as the place they want to have their birthing experience. When I came about 9 years ago, we had about 1,400 deliveries a year, and now we're up to about 2,400.
Wow.
So in an aging community, St. Mary is the choice for maternity care.
So I understand St. Mary is increasing the size of labor and delivery rooms as well as the NICU, so there's more privacy for new mothers and rooms are more family friendly. Can you explain, though, what are baby best practices?
When you hear the term baby friendly, it's about encouraging moms to breastfeed with their babies and to room in with their babies. We know that breast milk is high in protein, so it is the best. Protein is what really makes the brain and body grow. And one of the challenges with premature babies is the digestion of their nutrition. Mm-hmm. And so when they're getting breast milk, it's easily digested and retained in the body, and they grow. It is key and vital to healthy babies and health and a healthy population.
Mm-hmm. So I know you guys are trying to raise money to outfit the NICU with these little guys.
So this is really going to revolutionize breast milk. It does two things. It warms bottles and it warms syringes. Mm-hmm. When babies are really tiny, they are not able to bottle feed, so we actually feed them, believe it or not, with a syringe. Mm-hmm. So this is actually made by a company that totally focuses on breastfeeding. Mm-hmm. And so they have taken all the technology and all the knowledge around that to ensure that none of those nutrients and proteins are destroyed.
Joining me now is Carrie Ann Smith, a fellow St. Mary mom. Now, how many of your children did you have here at St.
Mary? I had all five here. Mm-hmm. I have twin girls, 2 boys, then another girl. I had a fantastic experience here. I was first-time mom having twins. Came in, they were born about 5.5 weeks early. Everything went perfect from my C-section to the NICU to the nurses to the postpartum care. So it's great when you have the highly skilled doctors and nurses that are willing to educate you. Education is such a key. Every time I came back, there were familiar faces, and that means a ton.
My name is Chris Carty, and this is my beautiful wife, Natalie, and these are our 2 kids. Dominic, the scholar down here, is almost 4 years old, and Matthew recently turned 1. We live right here in Bucks County, and we're proud to say that St. Mary is our community hospital.
Both of our boys were born at St. Mary's. We've had to use the emergency services here one time for our rambunctious almost two-year-old at the time. And my OBGYN is also part of the St. Mary's family. St. Mary's is important to us because of its compassionate care. I had a scheduled C-section for my second son. I was nervous, of course, going into it. And I asked my nurse if she would hold my hand until my husband got there, which she did with no problem and said, I'll be here right with you until he's able to hold your hand. And to me, that just screams compassionate care from St. Mary.
As a father and husband, I just want to make sure that my family's taken care of in case there's a medical emergency or a problem arises. And I don't want to, you know, second guess if I made the right decision. And I just want complete confidence, and that's what I get here at St. Mary. You know, there's world-class doctors here. They're continually progressing. And, you know, there's so much that the hospital's doing right, but it's almost more the intangibles that I really like. You know, there is an immense level of compassion from everyone here. This is the kind of care that I want from a hospital, and this is why we support them, and they're just doing so many good things in the community.